fish passage is incredibly important because a lot of our native fish actually need to be able to move between saltwater and freshwater as part of their life cycle. And in fact, some of our iconic species in the wet tropics like barramundi and mangrove jack and jungle perch, tarpon, even things like mullet need to be able to move between salt and freshwater. If they can't do that, then the juvenile fish can't get up into the freshwater to grow out and become mature fish, and so we start to see a decline in our fish stocks. Fish barriers are anything that stops a fish from migrating upstream. And it could be road culverts, it could be just a road crossing, a rock weir, or it could be a weir and a dam, you know, really large obstructions that stop fish from moving up. It can also be flow velocity barriers, so small fish struggle to swim through fast flowing water. But a lot of the barriers that we have in the wet tropics are man-made barriers that we've created to enable us to cross rivers and so forth, and it stops our juvenile fish from getting up into the nursery areas.
In the wet tropics, we've been looking at fish barriers. That's things that stop our fish from moving upstream and to access large areas of their catchment. We have a fairly recent understanding of how these things are affecting our native species, and so we've been looking at barriers to movement in 5 of the 9 wet tropics catchments. We've done a prioritisation study where we found about 4,000 potential fish barriers. Those were ranked in terms of how important they are for our native fish. In the Barron, Mossman and Daintree catchments, I've looked at around 200 fish barriers and worked out that over 60% of them were actually barriers to moving fish, like the one behind me here today. We've been working with our partners and consultants to find solutions for fish passage in the region. We live in this landscape, and so we want to work in a way that facilitates traffic movement and fish movement at the same time. Ideally, we would remove barriers and replace them with bridges, but that can be a really expensive exercise. Some of the areas we've been looking at would need bridges spanning 20 or 30 metres, and that could be millions of dollars worth of spend. So in cases like that, fish ladders can be retrofitted. We can install fish ladders to help fish move over weirs and up through culverts and navigate those apron drops.
By improving fish passage, what we're doing is enabling our native fish to be able to restock and become self-recruiting. What happens currently if we have fish barriers, it stops those little fish from getting up and growing out. If we remove those barriers, we're going to have more fish getting up into the headwaters. They're going to make the headwaters of our river systems and our wetlands and those sorts of freshwater environments much healthier in terms of the species that are there. And they're also going to grow out and enable us to have a more sustainable recreational commercial fishery downstream.